Good evening, my lovely people. Hope really good weekend, everyone. Some of you saw us this morning. If you joined,
nonsense at all.
Sorry. What are you doing? Some people joined us this morning to do the hit session. So really good. That was a cracking session this morning, guys. Tomorrow morning we're gonna do a kettlebell session. Kettlebells tomorrow. So we've done three. This will be kettlebell session four. So what we'll do is we'll take some of the movements we did in the first three sessions and kind of amalgamate that into a fourth session. Right. Anyway, back to tonight. We're gonna do a chicken and bacon carbonara. We were just saying at the weekend that we haven't had pasta in ages. It's not something that generally we eat that much. The kids have it a lot, but Hannah and I really enjoy it. But obviously, for health reasons and whatnot, we try to keep the pasta in the evenings in particular, Dad. So if I do have pasta, it tends to be at lunchtime. I'll take it to work with me and I'll have it pre or post hitting a heavy gym session, which is always quite good, give you all that energy, sorry. However, you might hear Hannah still panting. She's just come back from a run, and I'm gonna go and do a good session on the punch bag later on. So, that's gonna warrant us eating pasta. That's what I'm trying to tell myself. Okay, let's go through the little list here then. So, traditionally, this would just be done with pancetta or bacon. We're gonna add a little bit more into it this evening. We're gonna do the pasta with its nice creamy sauce. I'm going to use the Philadelphia. I'm going to use some chicken stock and some of the white wine. Or you can go for the reduced fat one if you want. It's a little bit lower. I think I said 150 grams, so I've got two pots here. That's 125, and that one's got a little bit left over. So that will make us up to 150. Like I said, we'll make the pasta dish up. We'll present that in a nice pasta bowl, and then I'm going to go with some sliced chicken on top. Just place that on top, just to pop that protein content of the dish up a little bit. So it's not traditionally the most healthiest dish in the world. However, we've put a little spin on it, and we've kind of gone a little bit healthier. I did note in the ingredients list actually what you could have done, guys, is you could have gone even healthier. Taken out the bacon and gone with turkey bacon, a little bit of chicken, that would have also been really cool. Right, so first thing I want you to do is let's get some oil in the pans. I'm going to cook my chicken separately to the rest of the dish. Right, I'm going to butterfly that, I'm going to season it, I'm going to start it in the griddle pan. Okay, then I'm going to pop that in the oven so I can let it go, forget about it, or not forget about it, but let it do its thing whilst we concentrate on what we've got going on here. Alright guys, sometimes it's you could do this like you would do a curry. You could chop up your chicken, chop up bourbon, and have it all in the one pot. Right, but I just don't want to overcomplicate the demo, so I want to go chicken, get that away, and then get the other one going. Alright, we've got pasta. You could go with a whole grain pasta. I've gone for a free-form pasta. Alright, so it's free from eggs and free from gluten, that one. Just again, as a little attempt to make it that a little bit healthier. Like I say, you could have gone with a really low-fat one of those. Other than that, it's pretty good. It's pretty good. Right, let's get the chicken out. I'm going to go with three chicken breasts this evening. Still going to serve four. The kids, it's quite a filling dish, so the kids will have half a chicken breast each. All I'm going to do then, make sure there's no naughty bits on it. Let's get rid of any nastiness on the chicken. If you see anyone pop up in the back window, it's just Hannah's brother-in-law doing some decking repair for us. We've not had someone just popping up at the back window. Although you never know when Darren and Spencer might do that. Right, so three of them. I'm gonna keep that one back for later, a little bit of chicken fillet, nothing wrong with that. Just a little bit that came off. That one's all good. So all I'm gonna do with these guys is just to salt and pepper them. Right, so butterfly, if you haven't seen your butterfly and things before, it just opens the chicken breast out, it cooks that much quicker, and it looks that much bigger. So what we'll do in a minute is once I've cooked this, we'll slice down through it and just present that on top of the pasta dish. Cool. And away we go. Okay, I'm just going to wash my hands before I season that. So a little bit of salt and pepper. Thank you to Plymouth Live, who had us on their channel today, on their page today. They redid our mazaman curry, chicken and vegetable mazaman curry from a couple of weeks ago. So that was really cool. I don't know how many people have had a little look at that, but I think Cornwall Live get that one as well. So that's quite nice to have different people getting to see it, not necessarily for people that always follow us. Some salt and pepper. We've got a little bit of oil going in on the pan over there. So what we'll do is I'll just get a little bit of kitchen roll, take up a little bit of that excess oil. That's what I always do. And just always, and when you've got a griddle pan as well, just make sure it's nice and in all the grooves. All right. So with my chicken, go season side down. Right, chicken on. We're just going to seal that, guys. Yeah, we'll just seal that, and I'll finish the rest of it in the oven. So I'm going to put my board of white down. For any spotters out there that don't want me using a green board, cross cutting me. Right. First thing we're going to do, or second thing we're going to do, we've already done the first thing. Second thing we're going to do is get the onion chopped up. Right, so one nice big onion. I just don't want me knife. One nice big onion. Let's get a little bit more oil going on into that one. Heat's already on, let's just turn it up a little bit. So I've got that to about an 8, guys, medium high. This is quite a large onion, actually, guys, so I'm only going to do half of this, guys, because he's a big onion. Pop down to the middle of that one. Yeah, pop that one to one side. Only because it's so big, yeah, so if you've got small onions, oil means use the full thing. That's about twice the size of the onions that I normally use. Ah! Get the skin off that one. Any questions, Hannah?
No questions.
No questions?
No. The only comment was from Coochie, just to say good evening. He's cooking a roast while he's watching.
Roast on a Monday, Coochie? I was thinking, actually, what I might do next Sunday is a roast lamb. And what we might do, what I like to do with the leftover lamb, is do a nice lamb tagine. We might do that as a demo next Monday. Sally Smith made a comment earlier on, actually, just asking when I put the ingredients up. Guys, I'd like to put the ingredients up much earlier for those of you that would like to follow it. But obviously I'm in the same boat as the rest of you, and I have found myself caught out a couple of times by suggesting certain ingredients and then not being able to get hold of them. So, I will tend to do it on the day. However, I did do a big shop today and managed to get most things. However, I'm going to do it as requested by Trevor Huggins. I'm going to do a monkfish and king prawn curry on Thursday. Well, at the minute it's just king prawns. I couldn't get any other than monkfish. And I particularly wanted to use monkfish because it is really good in the curry. Right, so half an onion gone in. You could use the full onion, like I said, mine are quite big. I'm going to go with them with some green beans. I'm going to chop them up nice and small. It's just a nice way of being able to get some vegetables into this dish. Nice, I'm going to take the tops off those. Ooh, one got away. Okay, I'm going to split the group in half. Okay, and I'm just going to go for about a centimetre. All right, they can go in with the onion. Once it's all mixed in, I don't know what your people that who've got children are like watching. Ours are quite good, but I just remember as a kid, I was awful with vegetables. And I found it much better off if they were in a dish rather than separate on a plate. I'd always leave them to the end. They'd go all cold. They'd taste horrible. I'd try swallowing them without chewing them. Make myself
You're much better now, you're all grown up.
Much better now, I'm a grown up.
Coochie says Jane was working yesterday. That's why they're having it today. I thought it might have been that.
Yeah, nice treat.
Katie Mutton says, loving the chicken pie and the risotto recipes. This will be the next one we're going to try.
Good guess.
The risotto is one of my favourites, actually.
Yeah, decent. The risotto went down very well, actually, didn't it? Great. Where's my garlic? There he is. Yeah, okay, so I'm glad you're following some of those. Lovely. Really cool. Let me see this time. So I've got eating it first. Just send me a picture. That goes for anyone actually, guys. It's really cool to see your pictures. I'm getting lots of people's pictures from planets at the minute. Obviously they've got recipe books to follow. And I'm getting some amazing pictures coming through. We've got a private group. Our members are very, we keep it very private unless they want us to share their images and success stories, then obviously we will do, but other than that we keep all the clients' information and identities anonymous.
Not luminous.
Not luminous. Okay, but yeah, we've got so many lovely, lovely pictures coming through food-wise there, and just really, really good feedback from people saying that how they're trying things they've never thought they would have tried before, and how, yeah, just some of the flavours and stuff they can't believe, how good some of the things that are, and how small some of the portions can be and still be really filling, and yeah, so it's cool. That wasn't a sales pitch, but that does start. We need anyone that wants to take part in group two. The program, you'll receive your program on the 20th of May. We need everyone's forms back by the 13th of May. So if you're interested in doing that, you can private message me. I can send you some more information, or just go on to our Planet page and have a little look. But I'm not just saying it, it's gone down really, really well. It's highly recommended. Anything to add to that, Hannah? You've witnessed?
Yeah, no, it's just been good to see the progress, everybody really supporting and helping each other and just understanding what they're eating, really.
Yeah. Right, guys, I'm going to have 8 bacon rashers. You, like I said, you could use turkey. If I'm being really kind of good, I'd go with turkey on this one. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, you little turret. Let's go with the 8 one. The reason I'm not pulling them apart, guys, because I am going to lose that fat down the outside. That again isn't actually for a health reason, it's just because it's quite chewy in the dish. Okay, so I'm going to use a pair of scissors just because it's that much easier.
I don't know if Smalley's been doing some daytime drinking.
Smalley?
Yeah. He says, oi, chef, oi. Then he says something rude. Then he says, I love you. Then he says, both of you. Miss your pretty faces.
Well, that's just normal. That's just Smalley. That's not to say he hasn't been daytime drinking. It was Monday. Right, yeah, so guys, I've just trimmed the Smalley. Good to see you. See you.
No.
Yeah, be in contact with you. taking the fat off, I'm just going to take that into the little chunks now. So, yes, about an inch.
He's had no drinks.
No drinks?
No.
Early, mate.
Yeah, nor have we. It's only Monday.
Okay. Good. So we're chopping down through. I'm going to break all that up in a minute. I don't want that all going into the dish or sticking together like so. Right, so we'll push that to one side. Let's get that back on the heat. Chicken or chuck in the oven in a second. Let's get this back on the heat, get this moving around, and I'm going to break the bacon up into it. Alright, like I said, guys, if you just drop that all in, that's just going to stay in big lumps, alright? And then you're just going to get massive lumps of bacon and not really share it out to the rest of your family. Which, you know, if you don't want to, that's fine. They just get a bowl of pasta and you get all the meat and chicken. So have a quick look in there, let hands so they can see what's going on. Nice and close. So just breaking up that bacon. Bacon medallions is another really kind of health conscious way to go with it. You could reduce your fat content down with that. Already mentioned turkey. You could go completely vegetarian on this one, of course. You could use bacon. What is that bacon actually made of? I need to think about it, isn't it?
Sounds awful, but no idea. Yeah, it is, mate. He says, it looks lush. So shall we have a glass of vino?
Mm. Oh, well.
That's actually for the recipe, but, you know, once it's open.
Yeah. It's not like a good red that you can keep back, is it? Not that I'm a massive wine drinker.
You can't drink wine, that's why.
Smalley, did you notice? No, I can't. But it was 20 years ago last Friday that Glenn Roberts and I joined the Royal Marines. Don't know if you spotted that little post that we had up.
Some interesting pictures.
And some interesting pictures. Yes. Right. It's taken a little bit longer than I expected. It's breaking up, you know. Right, okay, well, I'm just going to move that around.
You could do with an assistant, really, couldn't you?
I could do with an assistant, yeah. Where's Olivia? It would only end up in tears. Oh, what do I need to do? So, we're going to go with a salmon dish tomorrow evening. Try to break the week up a little bit with fish. One night of red meat, one night of chicken. In fact, we've got two fish dishes this week. But salmon tomorrow evening with a chili jam. Samphire again and leeks. We're going to combine the samphire and leeks this week. Going to go with a little herb crust. So Hannah keeps trying to chuck away a stale French baguette that I've had in the cupboard. But I'm trying to keep it because it makes stale bread makes for very good breadcrumbs. So I'll use the top of my salmon. So the chili jam will be underneath and then the herby crust will stick to the top. Okay, so the good bit is going to go in a minute actually. So as soon as I've kind of cooked off this bacon a little bit, we're going to go with... What are you laughing at?
I'm laughing at how long it's taking you.
Therapeutic, you know. I'm going to go with a nice big glug, roughly 150ml, 200ml of white wine. Okay. So let's get rid of my bacon, which was very labour-inducing. Okay, I'm going to give that a wash off again in a second. Let's give that a nice stir up. There we go. Let's have a look in there then, Hans. So we're browning off that onion. The garlic's really starting to smell nice. The green beans are starting to get a little bit of charring on them, so that's nice. The bacon's just cooking away. That'll cook away really quite quickly in there. It doesn't have to be cooked all the way through before I start getting my other bits in, because it's going to stay on the heat, so it will continue to cook right throughout the whole process. So, nice big glug. Can we measure it? Let's measure it for you, if you're watching. So we're going to go for 150ml of wine. I'm going to reduce that right down. Okay, so wine's going in. And get the heat right up. So turn that right up nice and high. Okay, I'm going to get my chicken now into the oven. That's just going to finish off in there. So it's on at 220, guys, quite hot. I just got that up nice and hot to get that temperature up. I can bring that down to about 180 now. Lovely. Let's give my board a quick wipe. And we're going to go next. Get your, whilst you're just giving your board to boil, guys, anyone that is following live this evening, just get your kettles on to boil. We'll use that for our stock and for our pasta. So kettle on to boil, like one I made earlier. Okay, we're going to go stock.
Where's the tunes, Dino?
Where's the tunes? What's the request? I'm listening to Alexa. Play Electric Dreams. Keeps coming into my head, this one, at the minute.
Soundtrack by Philip
Oakey
and Giorgio
Moroder. Okay, so I'm going to just play it, Alexa. Stop going on. Woman. Just reducing my wine down. Okay, so I'm going to reduce that down to about half. Okay, so pasta. I'm going to go with about 2/3. Well, let's just go for it all, shall we? Okay, so you can see I just popped it. So I've got hold of the load of it. Now, what I'm going to do with that? I'm going to go in and I'm going to twist it and it's just going to fan out. Then it'll all fall in and cook nice and evenly, right? Might as well use the rest, can't we? What's the point of leaving that back? So a little twist on that again there and it just fans it. Okay, we are going to salt that water. There's no water in here. We're going to salt that. Okay, this one we're going to go for 200ml. sauce can go into the spaghetti. Okay, I'm going to get that on to boil. So bring that right back up to the boil. That's back down onto an 8 there now, so like a medium high. I've gone with about half. Right, I'm going to mix that in again. Right, we'll let that do its thing for a minute. Okay, we're going to get our parsley prepped. Way more than I said there, guys. You only need about 2 heaped tablespoons, really. Right, bunch a load up. Not one of my favourite herbs, but couldn't really use coriander in this. Any more requests then? Did any come through?
No. You have just turned Coochie's Alexa on though.
Yeah, we electric dreams in Coochie's house as well. Pass these set to one side. That'll be for a nice bit of... We will put some of that in, right, to kind of get around the... we get around the spaghetti, and we will then also garnish with a little bit at the end. There'll also be a little tweak that I will do, because I'm a chili fan, and actually this goes really, really well, and it just gives it a nice pop of colour on top of that white sauce. It's going to finish it with a little bit of dry chili flakes on top.
Yes, that was chicken stock. Someone was just checking. That was chicken stock.
Yeah. You could equally, though, you could use what, vegetable stock. It wouldn't make much difference. So utensil-wise then, guys, I've used quite a few utensils this evening. You don't necessarily have to use as many as I have. So I'm just pushing.
You just like to create more dishes for me, don't you?
Let's be honest. Everyone's seen the videos and how I clean as I go. What are you looking at that for? Boom. There you go. Done. Everyone witness that? Dishes. Done.
He washed a spoon. Did you see that?
Yeah. Alice... Right, so pasta's bubbling away nicely. Let's turn it down a little touch. And then we've got our cream sauce with our bacon, our green beans, that's cooking away nicely there. We've got our parsley ready to garnish. We've got a little bit of stock left over, and then we've got our salt and pepper to finish the dish off. We'll keep the stock to the side, because once I've mixed that pasta through, it might just suck up a lot of that sauce, and we might find that we need that a little bit extra. Let's have a quick look at our chicken breast. Go on.
Gucci says Joe Wick's wife doesn't do dishes.
Joe Wick's what?
Wife doesn't do dishes. No. He's got no comeback.
No. Who is Joe Wicks? On that note, who is Joe Wicks? It's your time to come and lay the table. Ah, well done. Highlighted himself. Good, I'm just going to pop a lid on that poster. Got a small period here where I'm just kind of chilling and I can answer stuff.
You could do the dishes.
I could do the dishes. What don't I need yet? I don't need the...
No, it's all right.
There we go. I've got my noodle fork out ready in a minute, also known as the back scratcher, also known as Livia's hairbrush when Hannah's away. Not that she needs me to do her hair anymore, but back in the day. Knife done. There we go, look. Everything's looking nice and tidy. So I've got myself four nice bowls. If you've got some nice pasta bowls, always look quite nice in those.
Smalley obviously wasn't in at the beginning. He's just put, who just walked past your back window? It's our brother-in-law, mate. He's doing some work for us in the garden. It's not just some random.
It's Hannah's gardener, Kimchi. She's got a gardener around.
My sister's watching.
All right. Keep it in the family. Oi, oi. Right. Now, but I'm going to give that a little taste. See what kind of seasoning I need in there, if any.
Pepper.
A bit of pepper, I think. Hannah, you're quite right.
I know, I can see that.
It's already got enough. It's got that saltiness to it already. That'll be from that one. That'll be from the stock.
Right, so and the bacon, probably.
And the bacon, quite right. Yeah, so you've got the salt from the bacon and the stock. Can you look? You've been listening to me when I've been doing these things.
Well, sort of. Okay. If I haven't been drinking wine.
So a little dash of pepper. We'll also use that at the end, and I'll just do a little bit of pepper on top of that in a minute. Okay, I'm going to get one more ingredient out for serving. And when you're having a carbonara, it's always nice. Have a little bit of parmesan. I think everyone's a fan. But proper fresh parmesan, rather than that dried, horrible stuff you get in the pots, this stuff is good. Right? Now you could shave it, give it a nice good shaving. I'm just going to use a speed peeler and get some nice rustic bits of that on the top there in a second. Right, let me have a little look at this pasta. That is literally the only thing we are waiting for here at the minute. I'm going to have to drain that off in a second. So what I find with wheat and gluten-free pasta is it does stick together a little bit more, so I'm going to run that through some hot water in a minute, maybe even a little bit of oil, that'll break it up. But it's not quite there. So I'm going to put that kettle on again. Right, we're about 5 minutes out, guys. 5 minutes out until we serve.
Brody.
Yeah, still a bit al dente that. Cool. Right, so I'm going to get half of that parsley in there. I said we'd use half of it in the actual dish, and then we'll keep the other half back just for serving at the end. A little garnish. Yeah, a lot of those green bits will grip hold of the pasta. That'll give the pasta a nice bit of colour. Yeah, we don't need the rest of that stock just yet. It's not looking too bad. Okay, cool.
Oh, that smells delicious.
Smells delicious, mate, is it?
Mm-hmm.
paying for the comments. However, he does want to watch the new Star Wars tonight. Oh, Coochie will like you. And Fat Coochie and Small, you'll both like what you got on tonight.
Come round here, look.
Who have you got on your back?
No one.
No one on the back of that one?
Remember,
Ian
was going to do
salmon.
He
oh,
needs to get
salmon. Good, Ian. Right, okay, we'll chase him up, shall we? Good, mate. So, there's a table for us. Nice bit of pasta coming your way. You hungry?
Yeah.
He's always hungry.
Yeah, so tomorrow night, it's quite quick, guys. Salmon will be quite quick tomorrow, isn't it? We'll pan fry the salmon first of all. We'll get the chilli jam on top. We'll burn up our own crust with a little bit of coriander, some oil. Get that on top, we'll bang that in the oven. We'll finish that off in the oven. And then we'll do a nice ginger garlic, cream leeks, a bit of Thai sweet chilli sauce with samphire and leeks. That'll be our base, and then we'll have that nice little sandwich. It's a nice, quick, simple dish. No, not loads of elements to it. A lot lighter than this one. So this is quite a calorific, larger meal. That tomorrow night will be quite a light, quick meal. All right. Good.
What are we having tomorrow?
We're having salmon tomorrow, son. So sure, I like this wheat and gluten-free pastry notes.
It goes a bit stodgy, doesn't it?
It goes a bit stodgy. Definitely have to work on that. Make sure we separate it. So let's get the colander out. I did salt that as well, so I might give it a little bit more salt in the pasta. See if we can just break up some of that starch. Turn that one down a little bit now. It's starting to thicken just that little bit, but I'm not worried about that because I've got my stock. If I need it, that stock ready to go. Sauce is looking nice. Okay, I'm going to go with a little bit more water in this pasta. See if we can break that up a little bit more. And I've got that. I'm going to keep that to one side, and I'll run that through in a minute. Keep running that through in a second. So, like I said, it's just this that we're waiting for, guys. The chicken's ready, the sauce is ready. I normally stir pasta so much, but it's just where it's all holding together. Hey ho, we'll give it 2 minutes and then we'll strain. Like I said, I might go through that. I've got a nice bit, and I tend to do this, guys. If you get any nice sun-dried tomatoes, loads and loads of flavour in those oils. So what I'm going to do with that in a minute is this is infused with Italian marinade, sweet and tangy flavour. So I'm just going to go through that in a minute because it's sticking together. That's the perfect time for me just to go through the oil, and just give it a moving around and just make sure we break up all those bits. Right, I'm going to take my chicken out and I'm going to start to slice that. Let's get that ready. So we've got a nice bit of colour on our chicken. Just got a nice plump breast there. Right, so let's get my knife back out. Let's just grab another one. Let's just grab this one. Okay, guys, all I'm going to do that there then. Nice and thin. And we'll serve that in a minute with the seasoned side up.
That must be boiling.
It's a little bit warm. Let's have another look at that pasta. I think this pasta's annoying me now.
Yeah.
Okay.
Bit better?
Yeah.
That looks better.
Let's have a look. Definitely needs your business though, guys. Really, considering it's gluten free, it's really kind of starchy. You can see how the water's really kind of really cloudy. Right, so let's just get that. Just get that through the thingy. sandwich up at the bottom. Don't worry about that. Right, so I'm going to go through that. Some nice fresh water. Now I'm going to go through it again. Just a little bit of that oil. So if you looked at it and think, oh wow, there's a lot of oil gone in, most of that has run through there. I can use that noodle fork to move that around again.
Would you recommend fresh pasta normally?
Yeah, definitely. If you get it. Yeah, it's quite hard. Pasta's quite hard at the minute. Everyone seems to be stocking up on pasta and rice. That's why they'll only let you have three of them at the supermarket. So fresh pasta and that is quite difficult to get. Okay, so I'm going to go in with that pasta. Right, now what I need to do, always add pasta to the sauce and not sauce to the pasta, so I was told in Italy. Okay, make sure that sauce now really gets coated in that pasta. Right, that will help us break up any of those bits that are stuck together in that pasta as well. Get right underneath it. A lot of those green beans and bits of bacon are down at the bottom. So make sure you really get in underneath.
Okay.
Right, I'll just serve up one, guys, because I know a lot of you have been there watching for a while now, waiting for that pasta to cook. So, okay, right into the middle. Make sure you're getting a nice bit of bacon, nice bit of green beans. So let's go with our chili flakes. I'll clean that side of that plate up in a second. So a little bit of chili flakes. See what I mean now about that red popping off against what would normally be just the boring white looking pasta. Lovely. Let's get back there. Get that kitchen roll from earlier. Let's wipe around the plate. If you're serving up for someone, make sure all looking nice. Okay, let's get that chicken breast. Okay, we've got a little bit more parsley. And just to finish off then, a little bit of parmesan, and I will just go. I would often then leave the black crepe pepper at the table for anyone else that wants to put a little bit more pepper in there. So you've got chicken, bacon, green bean, spaghetti carbonara, or I'll twist on a spaghetti carbonara using a Philadelphia white wine and chicken stock. That's a good time at Gary's drilling. Thank you very much, guys. See you in the morning for kettlebell, 9:30 in the morning if you want to join us out there. And then tomorrow evening we've got a salmon dish. Take it easy.